What is up, everybody? Welcome back to the Binding of Isaac Antibirth today. Today we're gonna switch it up, play some Antibirth. You know, why not? Why not? I think I don't know. There was no episode yesterday, which is weird because I've been doing Daily Isaac for like a couple of weeks, if not months, consistently. So yeah, it was a little strange for me not to post one on Sunday. But I think I've kind of grinded out the Afterbirth Plus a little too much because I was after the daily achievement, which is basically play... Ooh, Holy Mantle. Okay, that's a good start. But yeah, it's basically do 31 dailies in a row, basically a month's worth of dailies. It's called Dedication, and I was on my way, and I was doing it along with Kate, and... she got the achievement and I didn't, and yeah, so something went wrong in the middle of my streak. I mean, I assure you I was playing it every single day for that long, but I don't know what happened, man. I don't know what happened. And it's not just that. I don't know. It's just the whole tonsil thing as well, the fact that I picked it up and I just didn't break it, and how close I am to the quote-unquote 1001% in Afterbirth Plus. It's just been a little bit grindy doing the daily episodes as well. So with that all being said, took a nice day off and now we're back with some Antibirth because I freaking love Antibirth and I don't play it enough, and the soundtrack is amazing, and we could play Eden over here. We could do some streaks because, you know, other than Jacob and Esau, I'm basically all done with Antibirth. I just got to do, you know, the challenges, but some of the challenges aren't even in the game yet, so gotta kind of wait on those anyway. A bomb for a tinted rock and a bomb. That seems worth it. Seems very worth it, and a coin as well to boot. So this Eden starts pretty solid. I mean, Holy Mantle right off the bat is great. And then we got Telepathy for Dummies. I believe that's what that book is. So there's no bookworm transformation. We gotta remind ourselves these things because... going back and forth, you know, to Afterbirth Plus, to Antibirth, you know, you could confuse a lot of things. Can we just appreciate how nice the recolor is on this champion monstro? Because holy hell, that is a work of art right there. The whole thing isn't just like an overlay. He actually has white teeth and like gums. I don't know. It looks really good. I like it. There's a lot of things I really, really like about Antibirth, and I could gush and gush about him, but... I'll try not to. Okay, so we have a key to access that. We also have a key to access the shop, so therefore, I'm going to run back and access the shop. We're also going to use this pill. Pretty fly. Not mad about that in the least bit. We also need to save two bombs to get into the mines, if we so choose. And this is kind of what I was looking for. So we'll just take the soul heart and be on our way. But yeah, I was talking to Kilburn, a week or two ago, the guy that the lead developer on Antibirth, and he was saying that he, like, you know, is really excited for the future of the game. So it got me excited, and also the whole, like, you know, having a launcher for the game instead of just running the EXE will allow him to, you know, push more updates, get auto updates going, all that stuff, which can easily, you know, progress this game further because. I don't know. I like Antibirth Plus. Afterbirth Plus. Don't get me wrong, I do. But as of right now, I'm a little spent on it, and I think that's a little understandable. You know, recording it, you know, once or twice a day, every day, and then streaming it 4 days a week, and you know, grinding to try to get achievements and stuff. It was just weighing on me. So nice day off and back on some Antibirth. It feels good, man. It feels right. Feels good, feels right. We're back in the freaking downpour. I forget all the lingo, the names, but we'll get it back in due time. But the Holy Mantle's good pickup. We actually started with some good, decent damage. We're going to take the Crystal Ball for sure. We're going to pop it. High Priestess. Okay. I see you. I love the little Strider guys. These guys are awesome. And the reflection in this is just so cool. I mean, it just puts the flooded caves to shame, you know? Oh, that was really close. Okay, he's gonna blow them up. Easy chain reaction. The Mantra's Lung, guys. Pretty difficult to dodge that first shot. So we got our item room. It's Curse of the Lost. We didn't get our shot, but a full health card. Okay. And we're fighting, what is this guy's name? I forget. I was gonna say Downpour, but that is the name of the level we're on. We gotta remember that the bombs take a while to explode as well. A lot longer than they do on, you know, Afterbirth. Also, we gotta remember his patterns. This is all pretty self-explanatory. He chases you down, but then he's gonna come out of the wall, or he's gonna put his head up. Yeah, okay, another jump. Okay, I did not, okay, yeah, he went right back in the hole. Because I was gonna say, his pattern seems a little bit off. He shouldn't have jumped again. Yeah, that was very close for us getting hit. I'm a bit surprised with how well that just went. Considering, you know what? I'm going to take this health up because this is the old deal with the devil precedent. Okay, so we'll take this. And we'll take this. I'm pretty sure that just empties your red hearts. Believe me, dry. It's a little bit of a damage up. Oh, yeah, I forgot about this. Actually, how do you do it? F6? Okay, there you go. Yeah, it's a little bit of a damage up and a speed up, I think, if I'm not mistaken. Okay, we're not going to check out the shop because we don't have a key. And yeah, we got two bombs for the mines on the next floor. We need a key for the item room because we have a chance at two items. That was bleed me dry hurting me, not an enemy, even though it seems like it sometimes. But yeah, you can see that little red glow around us. Pretty sure it gives us a little bit of a damage boost. And what else did we get? Guppy's tail. Yeah, Guppy's tail, solid. We still don't have a key, and now we found a chest as well. Well, right then. But usually, you know, Downpour is definitely harder than, like, the cellar or something. And we're doing pretty well, so nothing to complain about here. I think Petrified Poop is a pretty good pickup here, considering, you know, money has been sort of a sore spot on this run so far. I hope the levels are okay. I'm getting this overwhelming sensation that the music is too loud. Oops, I didn't mean to do that. Oh, we're gonna have to fight that room again. Oh, no, we're not. Okay, never mind. We're good. We're good. But yeah, I'm just getting this overwhelming sensation that the music is loud. I don't know. It's all different levels from Afterbirth because it's a different client. It's not like a modded Afterbirth. Shoot these, and we're going to use the Crystal Ball. Temperance and a High Priestess card. Okay, I mean, all just kind of whatever. I know I use a bomb here. I kind of regret it, but we could always buy a bomb in the shop. If need be, we can go in here for free. We have Holy Mantle. Something we gotta kind of remind ourselves is that we have Holy Mantle. You usually don't get it this early, and it's not like we're playing as the Lost or something, where he starts with it. All right, let's go check out this secret room up here, courtesy of a Crystal Ball. Let's make sure we, you know, kite the Striders the way you need to. Oh, that's bull. That's bull. It's all right. We have Holy Mantle, so it really didn't hurt us. But yeah, the Striders are always a little bit difficult to deal with just for the sheer fact that they can go over these void spaces. Okay. I know. I'm using the bombs. Why am I using the bombs? Because I haven't played this in a while. All right. That's going to be my excuse. We need the bombs to get to the mines. We also can, you know, do another floor, like a normal floor, and then hop back into the mines if we get bombs. But we did get a key, which is very important. We should go back for the item room. No bombs dropped there, which is never good. But we do have another big room down here connected to our shop. Which I don't know how viable the shop is going to be. Because consumables are just are a little rare right now. Not the best. Definitely not the best. We're going to just take Sack of Pennies. And yeah, we'll check out this big room because we need some bombs. We need some bombs, and we're almost at 15 cents, so maybe another key wouldn't be the worst thing. Okay, that guy kind of was, like, dwelling over that rock. Wasn't sure which one to pick up. I'm totally okay with that. I think that champion actually dropped us a key, which, you know, I just kind of mentioned that we should access the shop, and that'll definitely allow us. That'll definitely allow us to do so. God, this soundtrack's so good. It's, like, sidetracking me. Like, I'm just thinking about it. The soundtrack's too good. It's too good. This shop, though, on the other hand, not so good. Not so good. Not even a bomb. So the chances of us getting into the mines right away are looking, you know, slim right now. Hopefully these champions drop something. Maybe a bomb. Oh, we dropped a nickel. Which isn't bad. It's kind of like a bomb. Same value. Well, there's one bomb. We have two more rooms. Okay, just got to make sure we get away from the Majra's Lung guy. And we did. And we did. Ooh, he spawned that guy slug real quick. Okay, a key. Well, we could go back for... Yeah, we'll take the knife pieces. We got to remember to get all of them. But yeah, we'll go back for the golden chest. I was going to say, you never know. There could be a bomb in there, but there wasn't. All right. You never know. The boss could give us a bomb. I mean, either way, we could always squeeze back into the mines if we go to another normal floor and get a bomb. But I'm trying to save my crystal ball play for the next floor. What am I doing? Why'd I use a bomb there? I did it, and I was like, why am I doing this? And it was already too late. That's just, I don't know, man. It's like habit playing just normal Isaac when you don't, like, really need consumables like that. Okay. Well, it didn't really matter considering we weren't going to use the bomb here anyway. I mean, it will matter on the next floor if we don't end up getting what we need. The thing is, like, who really cares? We could always just go the old way and fight, There we go. We could go the old way and just fight Blue Baby and Isaac, because why not? Okay, so we don't have a key because I used it on that chest trying to get a late bomb there. Another battery, another charge, though. Okay, there's one bomb, and the freaking soul hearts aplenty right now. We're fighting Krampus. He can't shoot diagonally, and he also can't spin it, I don't think. Pretty sure it's old Krampus, which old Krampus was annoying enough. I don't know why they added the new attacks. I guess enemies are, you know, to a degree supposed to be annoying and difficult and challenging, but... Do I do it? Yeah. Oh, I'm happy I did. I'm happy I did. Now, I'm going to hold on to this red heart, one, for deals with the devil, and two, because I don't know if the cross works if you don't have any red hearts for it to hurt. I don't know. I'm not sure exactly. The blood oath I'm talking about, the cross that's following me around that hurts me every floor, I don't know. I don't know if it would hurt our soul hearts, which maybe I wouldn't be too fond of. But it's, I don't know. I'm just kind of trying to hold it close to my chest here. But growth hormones on the last floor was a big pickup. We already touched Guppy's tail, and that's Guppy's paw. So one item away from Guppy, which is awesome. I'm actually going to high priestess my man right here. Speed this up a little bit. Got another key, or a key. Sorry, we had a bomb. Box of spiders, not great. That's all right. We'll touch it, use it, and move on. I'm hoping for another key so we could access this shop, because 25 cents is pretty significant. There's a lot of good shop items in Antibirth. I'm looking at you, Birthright. I'm looking at you. I'm not exactly sure what it does for Eden, but it does something different for every character. Forgot about these spiders. Oh, the Guppy dream. I thought it was real. All right, we have broken stopwatch and another soul heart. You know, I'll just take broken stopwatch. Might as well, you know, spend some money while we can. Who knows if we're going to be able to access any future shops. The mines, I think, is the hardest level in Antibirth. So, you know, skipping one of them might not be the worst idea. The only problem is we still only have one bomb. There's a bomb in here, though. You know what? We're just going to buy this bomb just because. We're going to go down here to go into the curse room because we are one Guppy item away and we can go to the curse room for free courtesy of Holy Mantle. So it's a no-brainer. It's a no-brainer to go check it out. And we could still get the knife piece because we're going to be coming up on the mines too. I believe we'll be coming up on the mines too. I think this is the point of the level where I save my crystal ball charge. I don't think there's a battery around. Plus, we're getting close to max HP, so. Oh, I think Pretty Fly just saved me there. I mean, Holy Mantle had my back anyway, but I think Pretty Fly saved me from losing my Holy Mantle. Guppy. Oh, you're killing me. We had the broken stopwatch here for sure. Tears up. I'll take that all day. I'll take that all day, baby. Yeah, let's just get out of here. I mean, I know there's a mini, we'll go to the mini boss fight. It could be super lost. It could be 9 lives. It's a stretch, but it's a possibility. It's Envy, so it basically could be shoop-de-whoop. Maybe some keys or bombs would be good. We definitely are going to have enough. If the run keeps going at this rate, we're going to have enough to get to the mausoleum. Monastery? Oh, God. I don't know. I don't know which one it is. I remember I kept getting it wrong. Like, half on purpose, half not. Well, in the beginning, it wasn't on purpose. And then I started to do it wrong on purpose. And now I don't even know what's up and what's down. We have enough bombs now to access this secret room. We have enough bombs now to access these mushrooms in hopes for mini mush or magic mush. Okay, we needed 2. Speed down. I'll take that trade. Speed down and a tears up. I'll take that because our speed is still pretty okay. 1.53. We have 2 bombs to get out of here and get to the mines. This is good, man. This is good. This run is solid. Liking this Eden run. Of course they gotta tempt me with not only a peep fight that takes forever, that makes me wanna bomb them, but they gotta tempt me with a tinted rock as well. I don't know really, I think he's broken. He shouldn't be jumping straight up and down. I understand he's not jumping left and right because he's kinda locked inside these boxes. Or unless the slowing effect has, like, got him not being able to move laterally. I don't really know. See how he's jumping straight up? That feels very broken to me. Yeah, I don't know. Maybe it's the slowing thing. That's an amazing trinket to get right now, though. We'll just pop in here. Oh, yeah, this is the Krampus fight. Derp. Caffeine pill. And we'll do this twice. We can't access that tinted rock if we want to get to the mines. But we got a huge luck up because we did a perfect fight there. There's another tinted rock, which I can't really do anything about. Holding the crystal ball until the end here. Or sorry, the beginning. Oh, that ripped our trinket. I didn't even think about that. I didn't even think about that. That's okay. It's all right. Hey, I've never seen one of these rooms before. I've never seen one. I've seen it, like, but I've never seen it personally. I've never actually been able to access one of these. This is unlocked by picking up a bunch of, it's called the Stars Are Showing or something. But we got it, man. I've never actually seen one in game personally. And I think I saw one in a video once, but I wasn't really paying attention to what was inside it or anything on purpose. I was like, oh, I don't want to know about that until I figure out what that's all about, you know? So I'm excited to check it out. Hopefully we get a key. That excites me. It's a different type of item room. All I remember is it said the stars are calling and it unlocked unlocked a room like that. Some sort of achievement in Antibirth. God, this game's so fun, man. I'm really happy I decided to dip back into Antibirth because I slipped away from it, man. Ever since Afterbirth Plus came out, I got a little bit of achievement hunter in me and had a one-track mind for it. But damn, dude, these enemy designs and just the floor layouts and everything about this is just so good. So, so good. Okay. We're not really getting any luck here with keys, which is really unfortunate, but all right, I guess I'll hold on to the 2 of diamonds. Hate these guys, but we do have Holy Mantle, so not the worst. That's a bit of a bummer. Still no key. Don't do this to me, game. Wow, that went very well. I did not expect the room to go that well. Kill him, we should get a soul heart out of it. Again, no key. There's a knife piece. Dude, another tinted rock. I remember that about the mines, dude. It was always littered with tinted rocks. Kind of nutty. Yeah, this is not looking good, boys. Not looking good. I'm really bummed. I want to access that real bad. Like, real bad. Not even a bomb to check out the secret room. Luck up, HP down. Okay. Yeah, man, this is bad. This isn't happening. It's actually not going to happen. I can't even access that. Wow, that's such a bummer. I was so excited to check that out. There's, like, actually nothing I could do right now. Oh, man, that sucks. That sucks for sure. Can't even access this chest. I believe it's a golden chest. It is. The shop, nothing. Can't even touch that pill. I mean, I guess we'll take this now. Well, that sucks. I mean, we could get latchkey, I guess. Holy hell, Curse of the Maze. You're gonna be okay. Are you gonna be okay, Curse of the Maze? What? What just happened? Fighting the tough twins here. Okay. I don't really know the red part. Okay, there we go, there we go. There's a good bomb. I felt like I was hitting them with the bombs, but we weren't seeing much red. I know it only shows where you break it, but... Okay, not a bad fight. Not a bad fight at all. I didn't mean to pick that up. No deal with the devil. We got consolation prize, which is +1 to lowest stat, which happened to be range, which is like a trash stat upgrade right now. I mean, we have potentially 40 cents. We have 2 item rooms, potential of 3 items, or the chance of 2 and the guaranteed 1 other one. A real big missed opportunity there. I don't know how we're gonna fare on the mausoleum, but yeah, that was really bad. Okay, I think that was a champion one, so there we go. Easily cleared after that. Crystal ball is still very important to our gameplay here, because the mapping only gets worse. Like, the mausoleum's definitely the biggest out of the three stages that they added, and the what is it called? It's not the womb, but you know what I mean. Their version of the womb, whatever. Corpse. That's what it is. Yeah, that one is big as well. So the cellar and the downpour are not that big of floors, but they can get pretty big, especially the mausoleum with that like alternate parallel universe type thing. But there we go. We got full mapping just like that. Another one of those rooms. Okay, well, that's good, because hopefully we can access it this time with a key. Because that was a bit of a bummer. I wanted to see what was in there. I wanted to see what it was all about. I don't know what they're called either. I mean, there's some form of item room. I don't know exactly what. Well, thank you for exploding that tinted rock, my friend. My little boner friend. Okay, there's our key, and then we can enter. Okay, so it's some sort of Ring of Tears. What? What? And we get so many cards. Holy hell. All right, let's run out real quick, and let's use the sun in this card. Or sorry, the sun card in this room. Hello, English. Wow, that's pretty cool, man. That's a cool item. So we have a Joker. Still have the two of diamonds. A lover's card. The Fool, and a Moon card. So we could pop the two of diamonds, and then we could just hold on to the Joker in case we need to play it. There's a mini boss over here, so we'll fight him. It is Lust. Dude, it just, yeah, it does some added damage on top. I'm not exactly sure what regens it. I've never seen this before. Beth's Faith. My faith protects me. It's some sort of trinket, obviously. Like I said, I've never seen it, so I don't know exactly what it does. You guys are going to have to forgive me. I have been out of the anti-birth game a little bit, so I don't know exactly what everything does. I'm sure there's some people that have poured hours and hours and hours into this game, or mod, or expansion, whatever you want to call it. Consumables still escaping us. I'm not exactly sure if it's because we have Guppy's Tail, and we've been using a lot. I don't really recall using a lot of consumables, though. This Ring of Tears is interesting. I wish I knew when it, how it came... How more tears get back onto the ring. You know what I mean? I don't know if it does anything passively, like without the tears on it. I don't think it does. Just pop that. Chariot. Okay. Well, we've got a broken stopwatch play here in our favor. You could have a broken stopwatch play not in your favor as well, but this one, definitely in our favor. Lost our holy mantle there. Ah, that was the first time we got hit in a long time. That's okay, though. That's totally okay. Again, no key to access the item room, which is a bit of a bummer because there's two items in there and we get to choose, which is one of my favorite things about Antibirth. I mean, the shop would be a great too. It's not looking good, man. It's not looking good. It's looking like those rooms might escape us again. We finally found a normal chest here, though. Why is it that I can't access these teleporters? Is that real? That's such a bummer. This game's trolling me hard right now. Yeah, the Ring of Tears is good, man. I guess it regens every, oh, there we go. God damn. Yeah, it regens every room, it seems like. Wow, this is a difficult room. I like it. God, the recolored champions, dude, are so nice. Aesthetically, I just can't even explain to you how much better they look. I'm still holding out hope for the combination of, like, the best parts of Antibirth and the best parts of Afterbirth. I'm holding out for that. I believe it to be true that that'll happen one day. I was gonna go explore a little bit, but let's fight the boss. Oh, it's Siren. I rarely ever fight Siren. I don't have any familiars. I'm, like, confused or something. Yeah, I don't have any familiars for her to, like, enchant or whatever it is. But, dude, I fought her maybe twice in my life. Wow. Okay. Yeah, that is pretty difficult to dodge, not gonna lie. Definitely difficult to dodge. Okay, she spawns her own familiars. I'm assuming they would be, you know, my familiars if I had any. And then throws them at me. We've taken some damage here for sure. Okay. She dead? But yeah, now she's dead. Nice. All right, we got the halo. We didn't get a deal with the devil, so we will Joker card. And we could take that and be okay. We had two hearts, so the mark is fine. If we had one heart, we got to be careful. If we had one heart there, even though the mark gives us health, it would still, you know, bring us down because it's the old Wrath of the Lamb rules. Slowness here is good. It really, like, it... like, really hurts their range on the bones, which is a good thing. Damn, what? I mean, I want to do this because I want to access the item rooms. Oh, I have Holy Mantle. I'm an idiot. Okay, we're fine. We're fine. I'm good. Are you good? I'm good. We need to make sure we get the third knife piece as well. Wait, seriously? I thought my Ring of Tears would get behind that mask and hurt him, but it didn't seem like it was doing it at all. We do have a key, finally. I'm gonna hold on to Best Faith. I'm not exactly sure what it's doing, but I like it. Although that fire looked dangerously close, I don't think it was affecting us there because we were behind the rocks. There we go. A bomb and a key. Hallelujah, man. Pretty Fly is nice. I can see Forever is also nice. We don't really need a bomb for much at this point. We got a bomb and a key out of it, so it was worth it. Oh, thank you. This broken stopwatch is not in our favor, as you could probably tell. The music. It's so good. Okay, Ring of Tears, helpful there. I guess you should use it. Like, when you enter a room, you should use it, like, almost as soon as possible. Not sure exactly how I dodged all those tears, but we did. This guy is summoning them, so can we kill him? Yes, there we go. All right, another bomb. Happy I did this alternative path here. It is really paying dividends. We're one guppy item away still, and we remain to be one guppy item away. Tears up, I will definitely take. That is great. I love the little hut on the left, man. It's so beautiful. So beautiful. Okay, we got mom hands. Nothing we can't handle. Nothing we can't handle. These guys jumpers? Yeah, they're jumpers. They are definitely jumpers. Ooh, baby. All right, that's that. This is good. This is good, man. Although, a very difficult room. But, since we have it slowed, probably not as difficult as it normally is. But a clever room. So yeah, the daily achievement thing in Afterbirth, I think, like, I turned on mods, right? I turned on mods, but I didn't play the daily with the mods on. That's what, like, gets me, man. So I don't know what inhibited my progress, but something did. I saw that beggar there. We could play him. We could play him. Why not? You never know. He'd give something good. We have enough money for it. There is a shop, isn't there? Yeah, you know what? Never mind. I'm good. I'm good. Let's just go to the shop. That's flight. So yeah, we're gonna take that. And I use the teleporters anyway. It's fine. Curse room here. Nothing doing. Did not mean to use a key there. But we did it. I regret it, but we did it. Wasn't really on purpose. Key? Talk about regret. Talk about regret. Yeah, the one thing about the Ring of the Tears is that, like, even if the tears don't hurt the enemy, they still get eaten up. Like, if I hit the fronts of those guys' masks, like, my tears still go away from the ring. You know what I mean? We just, like, fought this exact room. Well, we got a bomb, not a key. But with this key, I'm gonna access the shop. Bet you didn't see that coming. You thought it was item room. And it should have been item room. Hindsight's 20/20. Yeah, it should have been item room. Oh, well. Oh, well. You win some, and then you lose some. There's nothing in here. Well, we can moon. Okay. What did we leave behind there? What card did we leave behind? I don't remember. This is a chariot. I mean, we're pretty quick, so we can move on down. It's only been a 30-minute run. I mean, the runs seem to be a little bit slower on... I mean, the chariot's probably the best out of those. Yeah, the runs seem a little bit faster on Antibirth, which is another reason I like it, is because the floors don't feel as long for some reason. I don't know exactly why, they just don't. Oh, I could get that now, and I got a key. Thank the Lord. Okay, Dad's Key or Lost Baby? I like Lost Soul a lot. And one, because we're basically at the end. We are at the end of this floor, so we're going to get a free item here, I believe. If you take him down to the next floor, he gives you a free item. But he also dies in one hit. But as you can see here, it gave us Magic Fingers, which honestly, probably not the worst. Probably not the worst, but we'll charge up our crystal ball first. We also don't want Lost Baby to die, if possible. I mean, that's a pretty tall task, especially on the mausoleum. If it happens, I mean, it would be a slight miracle. Pop this. And then I'll take Magic Fingers because we have 72 cents. I'm not exactly sure if it scales with our damage on Rebirth or Anti-Birth, but it's gonna be efficient, as you could see. Money equals power. Now that kind of just deflects all desires to use Magic Fingers kind of just got deflected there, which, you know, is whatever. We're probably gonna lose Lost Baby. Like, that was half the reason I took Magic Fingers, was because it could easily, you know, get us out of this floor without having to... Yeah, he already died. Without having to probably sacrifice Lost Baby, but there he goes. Just the walking down the street singing, "I'm just a Lost Baby, do-wa-diddy-da." You know the song. Everyone knows that song. Okay. We have blue fires around us. I'm not exactly sure why. Oh, maybe that's what my trinket does. That would make sense. That would make total sense. Oop, couple Bob Marley zombie babies here. Bob Marley zombie babies. Know exactly what I just said. We want access to shop for sure. Oh God, thank God I did that. Let's not open up any of these other gold chests though. We got blank card chariot. I mean, we probably just blow this dude up. Blank card chariot does not interest me. Do we check out this library? We don't have keys. How about the secret room? It's just one key. If there's a key in here, we'll do it. Damn. Okay, let's see what's in here. I mean, maybe there's a key. Gotta remember I have Holy Mantle. It's like being completely hidden by, I don't know exactly what, but cosmetically, Holy Mantle's being hidden. We don't have the electric shield around us anymore, but we still have the effects. I can guarantee you that. Okay, and we can't take either of these two hard deals with the devil. We could take the shovel, but we can't take the other two. Okay. Thank you for asking again, but like, still, I'm okay. We're still one guppy item away from guppy, which is a big bummer, and which is actually going to influence me to go to the other side. The upside down, if you will. And yeah, check out what they have to offer over there, because one more key... I mean, sorry, one more curse room could be a guppy, so... Why not? You know, why not? I love the mausoleum. I'm down to spend some time on the mausoleum. Wrecked. Bam, 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 bam. Woo! What is this? Lovers. I mean, you could make the argument, hey man, blank card's pretty damn valuable since you have crystal ball. And yeah, that's definitely true. But honestly, a lot of the times the card is just a soul heart if we're being real with each other. Speaking of soul hearts. And like a world card, it's like blank card world is like... I mean, the crystal ball is mapping, so world or sun doesn't really do anything for me either. Okay, we're finally getting some consumable drops. We got to start adding these bad boys up. I saw that was a golden key, which is good. Now the keys are dropping. Not really worth it. I like ran into that guy. He didn't get scared because he didn't see me, but I ran into him. But he was totally fine with that. Let's check out the secret room here. Hopefully Guppy. Hopefully. No dice. Getting close to 99 cents, but I think we just hit 99 cents, which is good. Lover's card, world card. It all doesn't really matter. Chariot, though? Yeah, we might as well roll chariot here. We gotta remember, the witness is no freaking walk in the park, dude. I saw a bomb there. It's alright, we have 12 of them. We're okay. We're okay. Alright, let's check out the library here. And we get Book of Rev. Which, no bookworm transformation, so let's just go. There's no real point in hanging out there. Guess we could have used the Book of Secrets for maybe a super secret room. Okay, another golden chest in here. The golden key is nice. I mean, we have so many soul hearts. Yeah, our damage is pretty significant. But we got to be careful of the mom's heart fight. That's what I'm going to save the chariot for. We don't have much damage dealing, like, you know, with our... orbitals or anything, so I don't know how much the chariot's gonna help us out on the mom's heart fight. Kind of have forgotten about this, how much they've changed the mom's foot fight, but yeah, not so bad. I forgot the damn key. It was right there in that big room. God damn it. There's no going back. Unless it's a teleport card. It's not. Oh, shit. God damn. I'm sorry, guys. It's okay, though. It's all right. We're just playing some anti-birth, dude. It's fine. We don't have to kill the witness. God damn it, though. I had a feeling something, you know, I was missing something. You know, when you get that feeling, I had it. I freaking had it. It's okay. It's all right. We still got to experience, you know, Downpour. We got to experience the mines. I was honestly surprised I remembered the first two key pieces. Look at these guys multiplying. This crazy-ass sci-fi Stranger Things womb sound music track. Hello? Freaking host. No, you son of a bitch. You son of a bitch. Yeah, I'm going to have to play Antibirth more if we want to remember that key more often. Straight up, or knife. Knife that turns into a key. I like when it slows down. Pretty damn cool. Okay, we got mapping, which is good. We're going to be able to fly through the rest of this. Also, we want to hold on to some keys because... We want to hold on to some keys because we're going to go to the chest now, which is a bright point. Even though we get four chests at the witness fight, it's still a bright point, you know? That guy's a turret. He just shoots. Bunch of champion spiders. Nothing to worry about. We're really powerful. I mean, we have, you know, money equals power. We have good base tiers. We have the halo all stats up. We also have, like, you know... The normal everyday damage ups on top of all of it. But the money equals power, I think, is what brings it home. We also have, like, the pact. Which is good. Making quick work of this, though. I mean, the womb is a little bit of a piece of cake when you compare it to the corpse, but still the womb, you know? I mean, this mom's heart is nothing compared to the new one that they put in. The new one is super difficult. Honestly, the new one is probably one of the only things I don't love. Oh, it grabs enemies' tears. I'm just noticing. That's sick. The ring of tears. Okay, still one item away from Guppians. No luck. But yeah, that's probably one of the few things that I'm not a huge fan of. Oh, we only did one womb. Huh. Okay. Okay. Got some mapping on the cathedral. Should be quick work as well. But yeah, I just think, I think it's a little too hard to dodge the bullet hell that the new mom's heart provides. I mean, I haven't fought it that much to kind of learn its ways. But honestly, it really doesn't feel like it's dodgeable. Hey, how'd we get Lost Soul again? Oh, do you get a chance to do it every floor? Oh shit, I did not even know that. That's crazy. I did not know that. Huh. I like that. I like it a lot. It makes this item even more valuable. Able. Why not? Ready, willing, and able. Ready, willing, and able. Gotta kill these guys first. Then we could take on Carrion Queen here. Try to take our lost baby out of harm's way. Oh, God. I'm trying to cheese it a little bit here. I love this music. You son of a bitch. He didn't eat the bomb. God damn it. Rip the lost baby, dude. It's all right. We good. We good. We Gucci. Clearing the Carrion Queen. We have so much money. We're good. These little guys move on. I was scared of telephils. I had a feeling it might have been for some reason. What is this? Another pretty fly. I think we're maxed out at this point. All right, let's go fight Isaac. Let's go to the chest. We have three keys, which isn't the ideal four, but it's not so bad. Considering we have Guppy's Tail, and it's just too eluding to not want to get some of the chests. We got Abel out of it, which isn't great, but it's something. It's definitely something. I gotta remember to look for secret rooms as well in Antibirth, because sausage is life, man. Sausage is life. Yeah, it has a chance to take the enemy tears, man, and like cycle them around your ring of tears, which is really cool. I like it. I like it a lot. It's a really strong item. It's not only defensive, but it's offensive. Ooh, just looked at that in the face. I'm happy I picked up Antibirth today. Like, I'm happy I'm playing it today. It just, it feels right. It feels right. It's like a breath of fresh air. Well, it's useless for me to take that. Basically, I'm just gonna lose it because I have Blood Oath, which it hurts me instantly. And basically, that's a 10 luck up until you get hurt. And because I get hurt every floor, it's kind of redundant. Okay, wow, that is the shortest chest I've ever seen. Holy hell. Yeah, Lost Baby, you didn't stand a chance, I'm sorry. Double cage, you're that far behind in the brigade. You didn't stand a chance. I mean, we're probably not gonna get a key, but we're also gonna be out of here really soon, which is crazy. I'm okay with it, though. But that's cool, because the ring actually gets... See, it gives me some incentive to kind of, like, dance around and try to dodge a little bit closer, which is cool. I like it. War went down pretty damn quickly. and actually is dead already. We have Pestilence, but we could fly, so he's not half as scary as he normally is without flight. And here we go, Blue Baby, just like that. I mean, it's a really powerful, fun run. There's just a lot of things working for us. I like it. I like it. I like it a lot. Plus, we got some good defensive items. I mean, Holy Mantle, obviously the Holy Grail, for lack of a better term, of defensive items we got in the first room. So there's that. And then the Ring of Tears is acting like a defensive item. And we had about, you know, 4 pretty fly pills, which maxes out at 2. Actually, 3, sorry. I mean, 2, I guess, when you have a normal orbital, but we don't. So yeah, we have 3 pretty flies. We had some good defense going on. And then money equals power, the pact, Halo. All that stuff kind of brought it home damage-wise. But that was a really fun run. I hope you guys did enjoy this. If you did, feel free to leave a like. It helps me out a ton. Also, I'm going to throw up 2 episodes right here if you haven't seen them. Make sure you go check them out. And yeah, make sure you subscribe if you want some more daily Isaac content. Thank you guys for watching. Hope you enjoy the Antibirth. Please leave this series a like if you want to see more Antibirth on the channel. I'm in the mood to be playing it, so you're probably going to see it in the next couple days. But yeah, thanks for watching. And until next time, stay safe, stay up. Peace out.